short because I'm hearing a fake divine masculine or a fake divine feminine has been trying to create blocks for you guys. So we're going to get a little bit more information about that. And I also want to say this too, you know, take what resonates, leave the rest. But also I've been noticing certain things. So I'm just going to mention this now just so we could just nip it right in the bud. There's like a few cross watchers who are watching my channel even, but no, there are people who are actually trying to mess with this collective and trying to do certain things to you guys. So I'm gonna be more mindful of that, what I actually say and whatnot. But then also, you guys need to stop trying to attack readers just because the fact is you're hearing stuff that you don't want to hear. Like, that is really dumb. And the thing is, you're wondering why your magic's not working. It's because it's not meant to. You're not going to be doing magic to people, especially people who don't deserve it, because you're doing things out of ego. And the funny thing is, like, you're so caught up in your own ego, you can't even see straight. You don't even realize you're living in a world of delusion. Like, you delude yourself to be like, oh, well, I could do this person. This is fine. No. Some of you guys do it because of prejudice, because you don't like that the person has differing religious beliefs or spiritual affiliations. You don't like that they don't have the same viewpoints as you. Some of you guys like to act like you're holier than thou, but you're not, because you also do some secret underhanded crap where you will sit there and do magic towards people, trying to cause them to have issues or trying to block their growth. Like, a lot of us see you and we know what it is that you do. And some of you guys even try to do things to get me off this platform, but you're not going to do that. You're not going to silence me. I know everything that it is that you're doing, and I see you. And when you wish negative on someone, especially someone who doesn't deserve it, who's not even trying to compete with you, who doesn't even give a F about what it is that you're doing, that's just focusing on self. One, that's dumb of you guys to do that. But then two, when the person's not even compete with you, then go freaking find a hobby that's called, gee, I don't know, working on yourself. Stop focusing on like what me or other people have building. Build yourself up. Like, you sit there and do magic and do all kinds of things with psychic attacks. And it's dumb. And then you keep wondering, why is it not working? It's not meant to. It's not meant to. And like, I'm getting the vibe that this person was trying to block you from, like, you collective, you from being able to have love, to be able to meet like your counterpart, your soulmate. For some of you guys, your twin flame, because not everyone is on a twin flame journey. And it's sad because some of these people are spiritual haters. Some of these people are part of the spiritual community and they act like they actually are for everybody else, but they're not. And then they sit there and try to do magic at people to try to stop them from being successful or having growth or having clients and stuff. Like, how disgusting of you. How gross. How petty. You do it because you feel like someone's more attractive than you. It's really sad. And like, the thing is, I've been dealing with this stuff since I was a kid. Always had my eyes open. But I also don't have to brag about what kind of person I am. Either you see me for who I am or you don't. And I'm not going to sugarcoat things. And I'm not going to hold back for what it is that needs to be said. Sometimes I am a little bit more mindful of what I say because I always try to make sure that I don't trigger anyone. But if you can't see if I'm pure at heart, that's on you. But some of you guys get jealous of me because I'm pure at heart. Or you just go based off of how I look. And because of that, you think, oh, I don't like that this bitch is comfortable with herself and confident and loves herself, so I'm gonna do magic on her. That is dumb as fuck. It's going to backfire. Why would you think that the universe and my own spirit team would even allow any of that fuck shit up in my life? Because you're doing it out of petty reasons, because your ego, because you're insecure? And it's sad because on this platform, I try to give information to be able to help people along their journey, but you want to sit there and be hateful with me being a healer and try to throw things my way so I can't help the people or lead the people that I'm meant to be a guide because of your own fucking ego, because you're jealous, because you're envious. Oh, this person has more than me. I wish I had that. Why do they keep doing this? Why is my magic never work? Why is this? And you're just angry all the fucking time. For what? Oh, they always get everything handed to them. And then focusing on me so much to the point that you're sitting there following me from fucking TikTok to YouTube and back and forth every single day to see, oh, did she post a new video? What's she talking about? Is it about me? Oh, da da da. Like, some of y'all are just way too obsessed and you need to go get therapy. You need therapy. But also, if you're getting triggered by what it is I'm saying, then maybe the message isn't for you. If you're getting triggered, maybe that should also clue you in that, gee, I don't know, this page is not for you. Don't come on my page and sit there and try to troll and try to paint me as someone I'm not. Or, oh, better yet, here's what a lot of people like to do. You like to sit there and use the things that I say against me to try to make it seem as if I'm someone that I'm actually not. You don't fucking know me, so don't try to act like you do. There are those who do see me for me, but then there are those of you, you're so caught up in your own ego, you can't see what's even in front of you. You can't even sit there and take your own, like, one, you get your foot in your mouth a lot, but it's like you can't even take your own head out of your own ass. You're so far up there, of course you can't fucking see shit. But you just expect me and other readers who are exposing you to be quiet and, oh, well, I want them to feel insecure and I want them to experience this and I want them to have that. No, you need to go humble yourself and go sit your ass down somewhere and take a good look at yourself. What you have in your environment is what you've created. But because of the fact that you see someone else or even see someone else on the come up, you want to try to take them out or destroy their success or mess with their finances and stuff because you feel some type of way. That's disgusting. And then you don't want to be exposed. You don't want people to know that you're like this. Oh, no. We wouldn't want that. That's why you come at us tarot readers so much. That's why you come at us psychic mediums, us healers so much, us shamans, because you don't like that we come at you and expose you. We give the messages that spirit wants us to give. But also, some of y'all follow us and you shouldn't even be fucking following us. And some of you guys will try to do on fake accounts. So they're trying to act like you actually support us. You try to also get readings and stuff like that with us. You're fucking fake as fuck. You're also trying to like steal from us as well to try to figure out what our blueprint is or how we do things so you can steal us. And then you're trying to sit there and be us. You're trying to sit there and do this thing where it's like, let me see if I can outdo them being them. Bitch, what the fuck? You look fucking ridiculous as hell doing that shit. But you don't want to look at yourself in the mirror. Oh no, that'd be too embarrassing, right? You wouldn't like what you would see looking back at you. Some of y'all even have an entity attachment to doing this type of shit. Not even realizing that, like, one, you have your own insecurities and limitations, so that's blocking you. But then those spirits are being able to ride on your energy, like on your back, because they're able to manipulate you because you don't even realize your own worth. There's more I can say about spirits in the spirit world because I know quite a bit about it, but I'm not going to say all of that. But yeah, like, I don't have to come on here and prove, oh, I can do this and I can do that. No. I'm not doing things out of ego reason. So if there are those who think that I am, hell no, I'm not. I do this because I have a passion for it and it makes me happy. But also because I'm being able to live my purpose. But that's something that you should be doing. You're wondering why you're having so much stuff, lackluster experiences in your life or loss and grief. And it's because the things that you're doing to other people, but it's also because you're so fixated on someone else's destiny that you're not even focused on what your North Node is. You're so stuck in South Node, you need to switch over to North Node, baby. What is your path? If you were actually focused on your path, you wouldn't be dealing with the stuff that you're dealing with. And some of you guys, you end up cursing yourselves. You're always thinking, oh, I'm going to be able to do this. And oh, haha, I have authority over this person. I could do this, this, and this to fuck up their life. First off, let's be real. Everything that you put out, you get. So if you're sitting there putting out loss for someone, negativity, ill health, whatever it is that you're doing, you will get that back and then some. But also, some of you guys have been doing this to people for so long that you just won't stop that. Some of y'all are either going to be put in the grave, I'm going to be honest with that. Others, you guys, you're going to be dealing with karma like this for lifetimes. And some of you guys are just karmic. You're karmics from other lifetimes, trying to see what you get away with because you're so fucking hateful because you got so much hate in your heart. You get so caught up in your own shadow. It's just, it's sad. And I could already feel from that energy, like there's a lot of people who are going to get triggered, but oh well. But the people who are actually, that isn't doing the fuck shit, they're not going to get triggered by this. But also, when you ever anyone ends up unsubscribing from me, that lets me know, oh, okay, you were one of the karmics, or oh, you were one of the negative energies I was talking about. But yeah, you try to watch me, try to see what I'm doing. Some of you guys are in competition. I'm not competing with anybody. I'm not going to compete with you. I don't care for it. I don't do this out of ego. That's what you have to recognize. But let me see what else spirit wants to talk about. With these karmic feminine and masculines, because it has to do with the false, I'm hearing false twin flame. Okay, we got the work you've been I have a spelling error on here, but the work you've been plotting or putting in will pay off. So like, for those of you who have been feeling like, oh my God, I'm doing all this and I have to keep dealing with all these energies, stuff, you can do this. Keep pushing forward, okay? Up your protection if you need to. Do what you need to do, okay? Another thing too is like, it is paying off. It's gonna pay off. Yeah, you had to deal with these little energies trying to like block you guys and do stuff. Keep moving forward. Do not let these people win. If they were really as powerful as they were, they wouldn't be having to feel the need to do this and do this constantly to you. That lets you know that one, you're the shit, but two, that also lets you know that obviously they feel you or see you as some type of threat if they feel like they have to come up against you a lot or come up with groups of people. Because there's some people in their groups, like I'm seeing group chat where they're trying to do shit to you, and it's like, it's really sad. Trying to wish you ill health, but it's backfiring. Thief, because you got some copycats. But again, that's like what I mentioned earlier. How are you going to try to outdo someone being them? Bitch, find your own fucking personality. Get your own fucking life. Get a life. Yeah, needs to mind their business, but is focused on you. Time to heal, but wants to avoid healing. Jealous of the attention that you get from others because you shine so fucking bright. Using other connections to get over you. So for some of you guys, like this is someone who's trying to use other people to make you jealous. They're trying to use another connection to get over you because they were toxic as fuck to you and they're upset because one, they don't have access to you anymore, and two, you move the fuck on. You're not focused on them. This person could have even been doing magic on you guys too, trying to pull you back in with doing love spells to try to make you obsess over them so you come back. Fuck that shit. Spirit was like, hell no. This contract is over with. This is coming to an end. You're not coming back in the collective's life. You need to go take your ass on here and go like focus on the life that you've created. Secret addiction. This person has some secret addictions as well. Some of you guys, that could have been like they're cheating on you with other partners, a sex addiction, drug addiction, substance abuse. Like there's just different things like that I'm seeing. We also have this person these people try to act like they're holier than thou. There's some people who watch this, who are going to be watching this because I'm picking up on this, or even watch me. You're in a certain type of religion and you use the Bible and stuff, and then you sit there and act like you're holier than thou, but then you do this effed up stuff. But you do effed up stuff, kind of like what I was talking about earlier, to people, even though you're judging the wrong people. You're sitting there trying to put judgment on the other people, and it's like, what? Like, you're literally using the Bible on people and then sitting there praying about them and speaking ill on them and their life. Because you feel like they should have the same spiritual beliefs as you. Even though, honestly, the fact that there's different beliefs, there's nothing wrong with that. It doesn't mean that anyone's less than. It doesn't mean that someone has more hierarchy over another. That's not how it works. And if you actually look at all of them, they all have the same type of truth, but just said through different things. Or there's different, even names, that's explaining a lot of the same practices or teachings. But you'll never know that unless you actually allow yourself to open yourself up to actually study those things. But yeah, you act like your shit don't stink, and you will sit there and fucking judge people because, oh, well, they're doing this, this, and this, and they're doing tarot, and it's against the Bible. But then you'll sit there and do magic and stuff like that behind their back. Make that make sense. For others, you guys, it's a thing where this person tried to act like they were better than you. And they didn't even really actually give you a chance to actually get to know you better. So it's like they honestly effed up because I'm hearing that you would have been the best relationship for them. I'm hearing you're the one that got away, but oh well. But another thing that I'm picking up on is like, like I said, they didn't get to know you better. And so it could have been a thing where, since they didn't really actually get to know you, they're like seeing you for who you are now and they're realizing that they messed up. But it's also a thing where it's like they're still stuck in their ego and they still want control over you. It's like they want control over your emotions. They want you to be distraught or upset that you're not with them anymore. I definitely pick up codependency vibes, and I'm seeing Capricorn and the Devil. Yeah, this person's obsessed with you and addicted, and they're possessive of you. These people are always in endless cycles. It's like they can't seem to learn the lesson, the karmic lesson. They keep repeating the same thing. Some of these people have been doing this for lifetimes. Curated a specific image of themselves to others. Yeah. And again, like I said, some of you guys, like, you know, there's those of you, like, you do tarot and stuff. You expose these people, then they get mad and they want to try to do magic and stuff on you. Like, how dare you expose me? How dare you think you're better than me? How dare you feel this way about yourself? How dare you go this pathway? How dare you live this type of life? Like, it's like a thing like that. And I'm just laughing because it's ridiculous. It's dumb as fuck. But yeah, they wanted to deem themselves to be a certain way that they are actually not. But they judged you, thinking they're better than you because you're spiritual, because you're empathic, and you have kindness and compassion for other people because you're patient. Oh, you're emotional, so you're insensitive, so you're weak. No, you're not weak. The people who are able to actually face themselves and their emotions are actually really strong, because to actually sit in your emotions and actually do that shadow work is actually, it can be pretty fucking painful, anxiety-inducing, depressing. That's why a lot of people try to avoid it. It's not easy. But see, these people don't know that. And they think that, oh, confidence means arrogance. And it's like, no, confidence and self-love has nothing to do with arrogance. But if you see it like that, that means you have a lack within yourself, and that's being triggered. And that person's being, you're being shown that person, or they're being brought into your life so that way you can work on that. Defensive in the face of criticism. This person and these people don't like when someone is giving them constructive criticism. They take everything that is a person says and they internalize it and they attack. I'm seeing like a dog that's being let loose, like just attacks at every little thing. Does not have any logic in situations, very emotionally volatile because they not think things through. They allow their emotions to affect the way that they make their choices in life and their decisions. So since they allow their emotions to dictate what they should or shouldn't do in life, this is the reason why they are stuck where they are at. But also, they create a lot of, they create a lot of enemies. Yeah, so some of these people also could think that you're very arrogant, like I was talking about earlier. Again, we got the addictions again. Spirit's doing a double confirmation. You walked away from this connection, confirm what I said earlier. Harvest season. This is your harvest season. These people cannot take away what is meant for you. They could try to delay, cause delays and stuff, but it's not going to work. Okay? It's not going to. And don't let these people try to have power over you, because if they were really powerful, they wouldn't have to do this stuff. Let's just say that. They're disempowered. They're in a disempowered state, so they're trying to disempower you. And it's sad because that type of stuff is taught and conditioned into us from a young age. So if someone's different than the norm, you get ridiculed or bullied. If you have your own way of thinking, you're a free thinker, you get ridiculed and bullied. If you're free-spirited, ridiculed, bullied. If you're spiritual, ridiculed and bullied. Like, if you don't fall in line with the way society says that you have to be, these people will come in and try to basically attack you. And they don't even realize that, like, they're causing issues for themselves too, because, like, they're sitting there not just attacking people, but they're sitting there, like, judging people because they're not like them. When, hello, people are meant to be themselves. And if you feel like you have to control someone, you're weak. You're weak. I'm sorry. I gotta say it. Wounded inner child, yeah. They're allowing their inner child to play out in a lot of these situations, and that's why they act defensive when they're getting criticized and why they attack you the way that they do. But another thing I'm picking up too with like the defensive in the face of criticism is like they will get so upset from something that you say to them and then try to flip it on you and get angry at you or even create an argument, even though you weren't even trying to argue with them. It's like they can't see things clearly. So it's like when you say something, they're thinking that it's a personal attack on them and their character. And it's like, you're not saying that. You're just pointing out something that you notice. Like it can be a thing where it's just, you're someone who could be very childlike and you're very observant. And, you know, you'll say whatever is on your mind, but you're not meaning any harm by what it is that you're saying. You know, you're very pure of heart. But it's like people take it the wrong way, kind of similarly to like what it is I experience. But one thing I was going to say though with that is like, they will sit there and I don't remember. hopefully it'll come back to me. I don't remember what I was going to say. Getting wrong info about you through divination. Yeah, they're trying, like, some people are trying to, like, get divination about, like, your life or what's going on. And, like, I'm hearing that they're, like, one, the evil eye is always going blind. That's one thing I want to say. But then two, they think that they're knowing, like, about your destiny or your life or what's going on. And, like, they're being given the wrong information purposely, because you guys need to stop digging in the collective's energy and stuff. And you need to, like, mind your fucking business and focus on yourself. Yeah, these people are definitely jealous and envious of you. And honestly, you're someone who liberated yourself from a lot of your own fears and insecurities. And you also illuminate things that needs to be shown to other people, especially, like, in terms of what they need to work on within themselves. And some people may try to come against you because of the fact that you exposed that. Love bomber. Yeah, so this person could have love bombed. I'm hearing the hell out of you. May all evil eye go blind. This is in reverse. All evil eye that's being directed to you is being returned back to sender. This person's mad that you moved on, that you're not focused on them, that you're not, like, you may have had this person on a pedestal before, because, like, you're someone, like, you're very genuine when it comes to, like, connections and love. Like, you put your all into it, and you don't come in with ill intentions. You're just not that type of person, even though a lot of people try to paint you as being like that, even though you're not. But yeah, they're mad that you moved on. These people have lack mentality, like I was talking about. This is why they keep having a lot of issues. This could be an ex-lover for some of you guys. And then this person was very manipulative. But also, something I want to mention too is, like, again, like, this ex-lover, this false divine feminine or false divine masculine, like I said, they're jealous of you because of the attention that you get from people. Spirit, is there anything else that you want me to pull out for this reading? Okay, they want me to get this out. Yeah, you cut ties. You moved on. I'm hearing you got on your sailboat and you've, like, sailed the fuck up out of there. You're like, no, bye. I'm going to go to where I receive what it is that I need. Go to where I'm valued. I'm not sticking to this shit. And you've been holding on to faith and know that. And also, Spirit wants to let you know, like, love is coming for you, okay? If that's something that it is that you're wanting, it's coming. It doesn't matter if these people try to block it or not. No, it's coming. It's on its way to you. Yeah, this was a karmic relationship that you had to deal with. Also, you've had to deal with a lot of karmic relationships in general. But yeah, these people are still resentful and holding grudges because you aren't with them anymore. You don't care for it. It's like they didn't want you to actually get connected to this life partner, like this soulmate, or to come into union with, like, your divine counterpart, your twin flame. They didn't want you to be, yeah, and they didn't want you to have success. They didn't want you to continue having abundance mindset, you know. They don't like that you love yourself and that you value yourself, but it's also another thing too where, like, they don't want you to receive your blessings. And, like, the thing that they were trying to block, again, like I said, it had to do with love and money. They're trying to hit you where they thought it would hurt you. These people don't even view you correctly either because of their limiting perspective on things. And they're dealing with a lot of turmoil. But you guys are letting go. But these people, like, the way that they, like, have, like, evil eye towards you, like, the hatred, like, the jealousy, the envy, it's, like, passion. It's very passionate because I'm feeling a lot of fire. Yeah, this person could have even, like, crossed your boundaries in some way, too. And you're like, you know what? I'm not dealing with this. And this person, anytime you try to bring up what was going on, it's like it would end up in an argument because of the fact that, like, they don't know how to communicate. But it's also this other thing, too, where, like, they would avoid conflict or avoid conversations as they didn't want you to bring up what it is that they were doing, because then they would remind them of how much they feel insecure, like, how inferior they feel. This person has a very fragile ego. And, again, like what I said earlier, sense of self. And this person, like, they refuse to grow, they refuse to evolve, and they're trying to prevent you from going to the next phase of your life, like your next chapter. Like, they're not meant to go there with you. Like, you decided to release the past, and you also decided to do that inner child work as well. But there's also, this person needs to do inner child work because that's the reason why they are acting from the place that they are, because they're acting from a wounded place from childhood. Tell me more about the shock, Spirit. Okay, so there's definitely going to be a sudden change that's happening that you don't expect. someone might reach out to you guys. This is gonna be something that's part of this new chapter that's entering your life. Something that you're gonna be learning new things from, but it's gonna help you to be able to expand. Yeah, because this is getting you prepared for union with your rightful person, okay? Tell me more, Spirit. Yeah, this person's still obsessed with y'all, still replaying the past in their mind. This person like was a runner in the connection with you as well. They have avoidant attachment issues. And again, addictions, like they, the obsession, restraint, possession, control, they're emotionally blocked, codependency. Yeah, this person could have acted like they were your twin flame, or, you know, it's like they did certain things to mirror you. So that way you be thinking that you're actually getting a relationship with a soulmate or a twin flame or a divine counterpart, but really it was just a mask. And so you're thinking that you're falling in love with them, but really you were falling in love with yourself. I definitely feel like you guys have been really focused on yourselves, but this person's been like partying a lot too. This person backstabbed you because, like I said earlier, like they were cheating and stuff like that. They're messing around with other people behind your back. They're still like reminiscing about you again. Like, I don't know if I already said that, so I'm not trying to repeat myself over and over again. It's just a lot of energy is coming through. This person's also in heartbreak after what happened and after this loss of this connection. And it's because of the fact that like they were deceptive and they kept lying. So it's like you learned the truth about them, and it could have been like maybe you saw a certain picture or something in their phone that led you to learning about this person doing this. And you were like, you know what? I'm not dealing with this shit. I don't fucking have to. So I'm gonna fucking leave. Like, fuck you. I'm gonna create a life of my own elsewhere. Yeah, because you're more focused on what makes you happy, what makes you feel fulfilled, makes you feel joyful. Yeah, and now they're bitter because they're missing you because you don't want shit to do with them, and they don't really know about what they're gonna do for their future now. Because they're codependent on you even for those types of things as well. Yeah, and like I said, the mask of this that they're wearing, it fell off. I'm hearing that it fell off hard. This person tried to gaslight you and be like, oh, I'm not cheating on you. It's like they could have even said some BS to you being like, oh, well, you know, if you were talking to like a friend that happened to be like someone that would be attracted to you, you know, they're like, oh, I saw like Joey, you know, hitting on you, or I saw Brandon or Casey like hitting on you, like, I don't want you really hanging out with them. Or like, you know, if you didn't answer the phone in a certain time frame, they're thinking that you were like messing around with them and cheating on them. But the whole time they were doing that behind your back. What a weirdo. Yeah, and they were stalking you for a long time, trying to see what was going on in your life, seeing if you moved on, seeing if you're dating someone else, seeing if you're happier without them. Just they would not release their claws from you. It's just they had to keep always knowing what was going on. They even may have like tried to do certain things where they would hang out in the same places that you would hang out in, or try to hang out with like friends of yours or stuff, even if it's people that you're not no longer connected to. So that way they can be able to see if they can run into you and meet up and talk. The thing is though, you don't want anything to do with this person. So this person needs to fucking move the fuck on. But yeah, let's go ahead and get some signs for you guys. I don't feel like I need to get the tarot for this, because all the information's coming through the oracle, so. Okay, so we have, yeah, this was a karmic cycle. You broke it, okay? So this person could be a Capricorn, or you could be. We also have Aries. This person was really controlling. North Node, yeah, you're following your pathway. You're following your life purpose. This person doesn't need to be, the contract's been fulfilled. Like, they're not needed where you're going to next. Like, so they need to move the fuck on. We got Gemini. There's definitely a dualistic nature about this person as well. Be one way one minute and then be another way the next. But this is also letting me know that this person gossiped a lot about you. Talked a lot of shit. Made up lies about you. We also got Taurus. And we got Libra. Yeah, they feel like you leaving and not being connected to them anymore is like unjust or unfair. They feel like you deserve... Yeah, it's like they feel like you deserve to pay because you left them, because they have abandonment wounds. Oh my God. My left ear just went to a really low tone during this reading just now. Like, it's like this person doesn't want this information to come out, but it doesn't matter. It's going to come out. So this reaches who it's meant to. Yeah, they got a lot of aggression towards you as well. There could also still be a thing too, or like this person still wants to boink. I don't know why spirit had me say that like that, but yeah. Like, could be mad too because they still are sexually attracted to you. Well, physically attracted. Yeah, we got Chariot. Okay, so Cancer, Taurus, and Libra, Pisces. You guys are a very attractive people. They really did not want you to move on. This person's stuck in their shadow. We got Pisces right here too. They got a lot of addictions and hidden desires and fantasies when it comes to you, but just has a lot of secrets as well. And we got Scorpio. Yeah, this definitely transformed you guys in a big way. And again, occult magic that lets me know that, yeah, this person was doing magic on y'all for sure. We also have Aquarius. Yeah, this person needs to heal. You guys have done some significant amount of healing after leaving this connection because of the trauma this person brought you. But I am gonna get some initials and then I'm gonna close out this reading. Okay, so we have S, we have H, we have G, what was that? P, F, W, D, C, K, and R. So that concludes your reading, you guys. Hope you enjoyed that. If it resonated with you, feel free to let me know in the comment section how it resonated with you. I'd like to know your story. If you like this video also, or if it resonated with you, also thank you guys so much for likes, comments, shares, and subscribes. For my returning subscribers, thank you guys for your love and your support. And also to my newer subscribers, welcome to this family and welcome to this community. But if anyone would like to be able to book a personal reading with me or a Reiki healing session, the information about that is in my bio. Please send me an email before you book. And I hope that everyone has a good rest of the day or evening whenever you see this reading. But until then, peace, you guys.